All right, guys, time to get into our first official NFL draft preview. The draft's going to be held virtually this year, and it's just over 2 weeks away. So we're going to go around the NFL by division over the next few weeks and take a look at each team, see where they're drafting, who they might need, and figure out how they can nail their respective draft days. With that in mind, let's start in one of the more interesting divisions, which is the AFC East. Brady's out, the Dolphins have half the draft's worth of picks, and the Bills can't be slept on anymore. So, Drake, let's go ahead and start with the Dolphins. They're picking number 5, as well as 18 and 26 in the first round. Who should they be going after?
All right, so the three positions that I looked at the most when I think about the Dolphins is, one, let's be obvious, it's the quarterback position. The running back position, listen, I know they just got Jordan Howard on a free agent. I'm not over-snubbing that, but you got him on a 2-year deal, so that means you don't plan on him sticking around long. So you're probably going to draft a running back that take you into the future. And then the third one was the offensive line. I feel like before we get into this offensive line is going to come up for multiple teams. You just can't have enough offensive linemen. Like, you just need that. And so with that said, when I'm sticking to the quarterback position, the first one is obvious, Tua Tagovailoa out of Alabama. If, you know, that's going to be, I think, their first pick, because make no mistake, unless they trade up, you ain't getting no Joe Burrow. Don't even worry about it. Unless you ready to give up the farm for Joe Burrow, you ain't getting them. So I think it's either going to be Tua, or they can go and elect to get Justin Herbert or Jordan Love. If somehow someone else trades up over them to go get Tua, I think Tua is the wild card in this draft. So don't be surprised if you see teams jump over Miami to go get Tua, and then Jordan Love and Justin Herbert are the two options. When I stick the running backs, the two running backs that come in my mind, is one, J.K. Dobbins, the running back out of Ohio State. I think that the package that he brings could make him the first running back taken in this year's draft. We'll see. It always depends on the team. And the second one will be DeAndre Swift out of the University of Georgia. Look, these two guys, I don't think you can really go wrong if you go with either one. The only thing I would say is you have to look at both guys when it comes to a little bit of injury. They both have nagging ankle injuries that I've seen. However, it wasn't enough to really think they was out and down for the count. Listen, that's why I let the professionals do what they do. They would dig into that. They would see how that go. But those are the two names that jump out to me. And then when I go to the offensive line, because of where they're picking, I like the guy Josh Jones of Houston coming out, because I do think it's four guys that kind of separated themselves from the rest of the offensive linemen. I don't foresee the Dolphins getting one of those four guys, but you never know. They got a lot of picks. They might make trades. I don't know. That's why we love the draft. And then the second guy would be Matt Hennessy of Temple, coming out of Temple. I see those two guys as the highest volume of Miami being able to go get them without making a trade. Now, if they make a trade and they trade up, of course they would get one of the guys. Worth, Wills, those guys. Benton, one of those guys that's in the top end of the draft. But if they stay where they're at in the draft as set right now, that is how I see those picks landing out, and that's what I got. Over to you, Jake.
Yeah, not a whole lot of differentiation from you with this. I think the quarterback position is absolutely something that you got to get solidified. I think we like a lot of things they've done on the defensive side. They got two primetime cornerbacks. Get some depth at the pass rush spot. I like what they're doing over there. So now you really got to pay attention to this offense. I disagree a little bit at the running back position. I think Jordan Howard, and you just plug in some other dude that you can find and that you let them handle the running back duties. I'd go get another wide receiver for Tua, who I think is the guy you have to draft. And to that point about if someone jumps them, if you're Miami, you can't play around with this. If you suspect someone's going to move up to the Giants at the fourth spot, you trade up to that fourth spot so you can get Tua. I think it's that serious and something you really need to get correct, because I think when you talk about Tua and Joe Burrow, it's those two quarterbacks, and then there's a significant drop-off at the next guy. So I wouldn't play around with that. But assuming everything stays the way it is with 5, 18, and 26, I like Tua sticking with that Peter Schrager mock draft that he had. I like Henry Ruggs. I think he's a nice complement to what they have with Devontae Parker. And then this is probably too high for the but where they're going to be picking. But, you know, Andrew Thomas and Mekhi Becton, big fella out of Louisville, and Thomas, respectively, from Georgia. Those are some offensive linemen I'd be looking at. I think left tackle is something that you really want to get solidified. If you can get your quarterback and left tackle, and then the cherry on top would be another weapon. If you can handle that, I think that'd be great, and you'd be set up for success moving forward.
Yeah, I would tend to agree. I think Tua is absolutely going to be their pick at five, no doubt about it. I think they're going to – it just strikes me as, like, the team that he's going to go to. I think they're going to make sure they go get him come whatever it needs to be. And let's be real, Miami has more ammunition than anybody else. You try to trade up, well, Miami, they've got more picks than you got. I don't care who you are, they have more picks than you, and they have more valuable picks than you do. So they hold the key as far as when do they want to get him and how they want to get him. And I completely agree. I think I would just go offense if I was them. I would be looking at getting at 18. I would definitely want to see if one of the Alabama wide receivers are there. Maybe Justin Jefferson's still there. Get you a quality playmaking outside wide receiver. And then at 26, you can always come back and get if Joshua Jones or another tackle's still there. Or if, hey, they're starting to they get to 18 or 19 and they go, hey, maybe this guy's still on the board. You've got a two, and two threes to move back up and go get another guy in the first round if you want to. You have 15 picks. You can keep them all on your roster. So, hey, you know, maybe you want to package up a couple, move up, and get your guys. So I would definitely be looking at that if I was them. But you get that three-man combo, or, hey, even DeAndre Swift, that's not a bad prize at 26. Let's go ahead and move over to the Jets. They've had 8 picks, and they're picking number 11. So, Jay, you'll start us off here. Who do you got for them?
I swear to you, if the Dolphins – not the Dolphins, if the Jets, the wide receiver position, please, please help this man, Sam Darnold. This – Robbie Anderson clearly wasn't a priority, and he's a guy out there as a number one receiver just overachieving his behind off, and he's not even there anymore. So I don't know who's going to play wide receiver, but you need one. That this is a deep wide receiver class, and I think at the 11th pick, you got to make it happen. I think it's you go after CeeDee Lamb, go after Jerry Jeudy, get you one of those guys. I think if you look at this draft, those are probably the two wide receivers. You probably flip a coin for which one you want to have. But I think you got to get somebody for Sam Darnold. As we move forward into the second and third rounds, depending on how it shakes out, these guys may not fall that far. But I think it's reasonable that you could get perhaps one of these guys in the second round. I think you got to continue to buffer that offensive line. I know they've been working on it. Feel like they've been working on it for years. Well, keep working on it because it ain't finished yet. Maybe a guy like Isaiah Wilson, another guy from that Georgia offensive line. He's a big fella. Maybe you put him at the right side. Not only can he help you in the pass blocking, but you got to think he's going to be, you know, a bulldozer in that run game. Maybe you get Le'Veon Bell going. I don't know. Maybe make that a priority as well. And then maybe get some pressure on the quarterback. I don't know. Maybe that's something we'd be interested in doing. Maybe you can get a guy like Raekwon Davis in there from Alabama. We got to remember they lost Leonard Williams last season. I know he wasn't getting a whole lot of sacks, but he is a guy you have to account for on that side. So I think protecting your quarterback, getting Sam Darnold a weapon, and getting after the opposing quarterback, and that's not all they need, but those are the top needs I got for the Jets.
Okay, yeah, my need is going to go a little different. Need number one is offensive line, and I'm going to say this. The reason I feel that way is because it's more quality wide receivers than it is quality offensive linemen compared to what's coming out the combine. So I think where the Jets will probably lean towards looking first is offensive lineman. Like I said, we're looking at Jedrick Wills out of Alabama, most likely. Or if he's off the board by that time, you're also looking at Andrew Thomas out of Georgia. Right. Either one of those dudes, you can't miss. If you get one of those dudes, you got you a top shelf quality right there. So we ain't mad at you. And then receiver, I do agree. Give Sam Darnold. Like, who is he going to throw to? The ref? We've seen what happened when you try to throw the ball to the ref. Just ask Josh Allen. That don't work out well, all right? And when we talk about those receivers, look, here's the deal. You got Justin Jefferson. Right now, his grades look like he's going to slide to the back end, to the beginning of the second round. That's why I believe that you can go out and get you some top quality product in the second round if need be. And then I'm looking at a guy like Chase Claypool, coming out of Notre Dame, coming in that second round. Look, either one of these guys, I would rather Jordan Jefferson. He's the known commodity. He's the guy that played at a higher level. Claypool is a guy that goes under the radar. But listen, either one of these dudes could come in, be plug and play, and give Sam Darnold somebody to throw to other than the trash can that he used at the quarterback drills. And then the third position I'm looking at is the cornerback position. It's been a little while since they had a cornerback worth talking about. I think it's been since Darrell Revis was out there, you know, calling the shots. All right. So when I look at the that position, now let me caveat. I got like a split here. If they go cornerback, I'm looking at a guy like Noah Nbengabi. I think is how you say his name, the cornerback out of Auburn. I'm sorry, he's of Congo descent. So the last name is a little rough on me, but I'm looking at him. And then, but let's say they say, no, listen, Le'Veon Bell don't act like he want to be here. We need to get somebody back there that want to be here. Le'Veon Bell still at the bowling alley. I'm looking at a guy like Edwards Elair out of LSU to come in and take that spot to give Sam Darnold somebody that he's going to put the ball in his belly and that he's going to actually give a rip to run the ball and not be out here on jet skis and crap. So that is how I'm looking at that. Like I said, offensive line, receiver, cornerback slash running back, that's what I'm thinking for the Jets.
Yeah, I think at number 11, it really comes down to, like you said, Drink, I think you said where you talked about how if one of the quality tackles are on the board, that's what you have to go with. But we have to remember, of course, this wide receiver depth on this draft is so deep that if you had to come back early in the second round and get your guy then, it wouldn't be the end of the world. There's going to be quality players when you come back in the second round. So if an offensive tackle that you are in love with falls down, and there's like probably four or five you could really say could be the first one off the board. So it's very likely by 11 with – quarterbacks going on runs, defensive ends going on runs, that they could be there for the Jets. So I think if they're there, I would have to really think about taking them. But yeah, getting like a CD Lamb type player to come in, man, that would be, I don't even know. Like, you look at the Jets roster and the receivers are hilarious. They're just, it is just the most sad group of people I think I've ever seen in my life. I mean, you know, Josh Doctson's your best wide receiver. That's not gonna do it. But yeah, I think definitely for the Jets, that's what you're looking at, is basically gonna be that thing there. But the bottom line with the Jets, they've got to realize you got a lot of holes in the team still. You can't fix everything in the draft. Keep your head above water. Keep getting the best player. Build your foundation and don't be reaching for players, because they've done well in the first round with a couple guys like Darnold, like Jamal Adams, but then some of their other rounds they've been kind of bricking on keeping the quality talent after the first few guys. So just got to make sure you're keeping it level. Let's go on and move on to the Bills, Drink. They have 7 picks, but none in the first round. So what do you think they're looking for in this draft?
And here's the deal. Like, this is crazy because they gave up their first round pick for a wide receiver. So I'm not mad at them. We'll see how that pans out for them here in the near future. If, you know, Bill Belichick has taught us one thing, hey, go with the known commodity instead of the unknown commodity. So they did give up that pick for the first round pick for Stephon Diggs. So going with that second round pick, I'm thinking they're going to go for an edge rusher. Hey, as good as that defense has been, they got some guys to replace. That's just the bottom line. And I'm looking at a guy like Khalil Kareem out of Notre Dame, just because the location of the pick. Now, don't get me wrong. I'm not saying this guy's the best pass rusher they can get at the time. We got to see how that pans out. But if everything goes according to what I'm thinking, that would probably be, you know, one of the top guys that'll be left on the board as far as pass rusher. Then I'm looking at running back. If the running backs get pushed back, you still got guys like, you know, you can get like J.K. Dobbins, DeAndre Swift, because I do believe this. As I look at most mock drafts, it just wasn't men and running backs. Outside of the Dolphins, I did not see where like a lot of running backs coming off the board. So you very well could get a top quality running back in the second or third round. It just depends on how everything panned out. It's not like a overly deep class of running backs. But it's just, we in the NFL right now that don't really care about spending as much equity on running backs as they once did. And then my third position is also going to be cornerback. And I wanted to say this. The Bills is one of the few teams that I don't worry about offensive line. Their offensive line has been legitimate. It's been a top three offensive line. So they're one of the few teams you're going to run across where you're like, oh, no offensive lineman? Oh, all right, then. Let's just keep it going. I'm looking at cornerback. I'm looking at somebody to play on the other side of Tre'Davious White. Yes, I do know that they went and got Josh Norman, but let's be real. I think Josh Norman's just a bridge at best. I don't think he's there to be your shutdown future on the other side of Tre'Davious White. So as I look at the projected picks, I've seen a guy by the name of Michael Ejimude out of Iowa, another one of those Iowa top picks from Kirk Ferentz over there that never go play in a significant bowl, don't play in a Big Ten. Neither here nor there. I'm getting off the rails. But those are the three positions that I see that the Bills need the most: edge rusher, running back, and cornerback.
Wow, that's impressive. We did not collaborate on this at all, and we came to the same conclusion here. I'm going to say this up front. I perused that Bills roster, and, you know, I'm not sold on Buffalo, but they really have a nice roster. I looked at it throughout. They don't really have any significant holes, especially when you consider that the addition of Stephon Diggs, so you actually have guys that kind of fit their roles, you know, as a number one, number two, number three receiver. They got them all. The offensive line, I don't know if it's that good, but it's pretty solid. I'd say it's a top 10. I really like what they got going on there. But back to the question at hand, I miscalculated. I forgot that they don't have a first round pick. So I'm looking at edge rusher. I had him at AJ Epenesa, another guy from Iowa. Well, you know, that's probably off the board at this stage, but maybe you get another guy in the later rounds, as you was talking about. And in that second round, on the subject of cornerback, I know he's coming off of an injury, but a kid out of Virginia named Bryce Hall, this is a guy who can seriously play. And if you could get him in that second round range, you're going to have the outside just taken care of for years and years to come. So that's one of the things I'm thinking about. And then running back. I like this guy, Devin Singletary. I really, really do. But you don't have Frank Gore anymore. So, you know, in this day and age in the NFL, you need multiple running backs typically. And Singletary is a guy. He's a bit undersized, so you might have some concerns about him wearing down. So I'm digging a little bit further back. I think he's probably projected a fourth round. I'm looking at A.J. Dillon from Boston College, you know, to balance out Devin Singletary. Big bruising back, durable, reliable. I think that's one of the guys you can maybe snag in the later rounds and solidify the running back position.
Yeah, I actually like that pick a lot. I was thinking about, you know, running back is what I think they're going to go with. I think they've lost enough guys there, and y'all are absolutely right. They did a really good job in free agency. They addressed their biggest needs there, and they are one of the teams that can really walk into draft day and just go, man, got no plan. Let's just see who's there. We'll just look at it and go from there. But and that's a luxury. Not many teams get to do that, and they're one of them this year. But yeah, A.J. Dillon, I actually like that a whole lot. That was a guy I was thinking more like Cam Akers is another guy I thought that would definitely be there that has a little bit of versatility. He can do a little bit of, you know, he can kind of run between the tackles, but he also has a little bit of outside playmaking. I was kind of thinking of a guy that could kind of pair up well with Josh Allen's mobility. You can kind of do a lot of fun things on offense. But absolutely, A.J. Dillon, if I was them and he's on the board, it might be a reach in the second round. But maybe they can trade back. Maybe they can take a second-round pick, make some more third-round picks out of it, and kind of bolster their picks, which is only seven.
Based on the projections I saw, and this is why A.J. Dillon came to mind, Devin Singletary, again, he's a guy that's on the smaller side for a running back. So rather than get another guy in similar stature, I like running backs that complement each other. I want a guy that can get it done inside, and not the Singletary can't. But he's a guy that I'd like to see more in open space. And with that in mind, you got to think about it. Buffalo, cold weather, snowy conditions. I mean, A.J. Dillon up there in Boston College, so that's why he's one of the – that's why he came to mind.
Yep. Nice. Well, let's roll right along. Last one in the AFC East is going to be the New England Patriots, Jay. They have 12 picks. They have the 23rd pick and then a bunch of later on picks in 6th and 7th. So what do you have – what do you think Bill's looking at there?
They need a quarterback. Let's not play around with this. I don't know. I really don't know if Bill's going to address this. I really don't.
Where Brady? Brady left? What?
He went to the retirement home in Tampa Bay. Well, he gonna play for a couple of years and then go to one of them homes. But hey, listen, I don't know. I don't know about this Jarrett Stidham stuff. I really, really don't. But we don't know what Bill's gonna do. But to answer the question, quarterback is clearly the biggest need. Whether they address it or not, I'm not sure. But I think I don't see him doing it in the first round, but I think it's one of them things where maybe Bill thinks he can steal one in the later rounds. It might not be the second. I don't know if guys like Jacob Eason and Jake Fromm will fall that far. But I'm just thinking of guys that the Patriot way and Belichick. You got to think about all these things, you know. I still like to see Cam Newton give it a try up there. But, I don't see it happen. It's a long shot. Maybe you change philosophy. Maybe you get a guy like Jalen Hurts in there. But quarterback's an issue. I just don't know. Yeah, I got Drink hyped off that. That'd be fun. But What else they need? I think they've lost quite a bit on that defensive line, and the defensive line wasn't that strong to begin with last year. So I'm looking at a guy like maybe Ross Blacklock from TCU. I'm just thinking of guys that I'm, you know, maybe we're not thinking about up front. You know, Belichick, he catches sleeping. You know, guys you ain't thinking about. He just make him into the greatest player ever. And then I look at the linebacker position. You lost Kyle Van Noy and you lost Jamie Collins. I think you got to rectify that. I think you really need to rebuild that linebacking core. That may be where you go in the first round. You need a playmaking guy, maybe a Kenneth Murray from Oklahoma, maybe a Patrick Queen of LSU who really showed us some things in that national championship game. But quarterback, obviously, but I think Bill's going to get in there and really solidify that front seven of that defense.
Yeah, my picks are pretty similar to what Jay said. Listen, quarterback. No, I'm just playing. But quarterback is essential. Here's the deal. We know Bill ain't the most savvy when it comes to picking these quarterbacks. He got Tom Brady, and he just completely whiffed on the rest of them. I mean, Garoppolo, you could probably say, wasn't a whiff. We don't know. He didn't play long enough in New England to know if he's really a whiff. And he seems to be pretty good with San Francisco, but that's Mike Shanahan. It's not Bill Belichick. So we have to keep that in mind. Here's the deal. I'm going to assume with these picks that these are first round. This is what he would do in the first round or whatever the case might have you. At quarterback, I'm looking at Jordan Love and Justin Herbert. I think those will be the guys that's left on the board by the time they pick. We'll see. Neither here nor there. And then the defensive end, I'm looking at A.J. Espinosa coming out of Iowa. And I'm also looking at, if they don't have him on the board, Marlon Davidson coming out of Auburn. Now, Marlon Davidson, don't get me wrong, he is not a edge rusher. He's a defensive tackle by nature. But we do know when some of these guys come out of college, they do learn new techniques. They do get moved depending on their strength and weaknesses. And then at wide receiver, let's be real here. I was getting better separation than the wide receivers for New England last year. They couldn't separate from anything last year. So when I look at the wide receivers, I'm looking at Jordan Jefferson. The reason I have him so late, I do see him sliding in the draft. I really do. Just simply because some reports came out. He's not looking as spry as once he was looked at. But I do think he's still a good wide receiver. He's just going to take a bit of a dip. And then I'm looking at Jalen Reagor coming out of TCU. He's one of those undercover guys. They talked him up real good before the college football season started. Once the season went through, TCU wasn't good. They wasn't as successful, and he kind of slipped because of that. But this guy has tremendous upside, tremendous talent, and I do think because of that slide of the season, he will be relatively available when they go to pick a wide receiver. So, yeah, I'm going quarterback, defensive end, wide receiver for the Patriots.
Yeah, I don't think I really think that they wouldn't want to reach for a quarterback at 23, but I just cannot imagine that they are going to go into that. They're not going to pick a quality quarterback to start the season with. I think that Jake Fromm actually makes some sense, but again, it's a reach at 23. But
yeah, I would. Yeah, yeah. To that point,
strikes me as a Patriots quarterback, though, right?
Right. Yep.
Yeah. Another guy, like you said, Jalen Hurts, another guy that's a senior, got a great head on his shoulders. He's been doing this a long time. I always think of these, like, long-time college players that the Patriots want to pick up that they don't have to get up to speed so fast. If they go outside of the quarterback position, I think A.J. Epenesa makes a lot of sense. I think that there's a relationship there with Bill and Iowa's head coach. And then you also look at guy, like, I think Denzel Mims could be a guy. He's going to be there in the later end of the first round. He's a big bod, 6'3", 207 pounds. He gives them something they don't really have at wide receiver. And he's a senior. He's played a lot of games. He's got a lot of experience at the college ranks. So if they're looking to rebuild that wide receiving core, which they tried to do and it never worked out, they could go there. And then, like you just said, Jay, front seven always needs a little bit of help, and AJ would fit that role very well.